Hi,
this is Amanda Chipman, and I work for Iowa State University Extension. Thanks for joining me. This is the first short video in a series to explain some of the data from the Iowa Pork Industry Center Pelvic Organ Prolapse Project. We are grateful for all the farms that participated in this project, as well as the financial support from the National Pork Board. Data collection started February 4th, 2018, and went through February 2nd, 2019. Each bar on this graph represents the annualized prolapse rate for one of the 104 farms during the year of data collection. The average annualized prolapse rate was 2.7%, and the farms range from an annualized prolapse rate of 10.3% to 0.3%. So, on a 5,000 sow farm, for example, 10.3% would be equivalent to 515 prolapses a year, compared to just 15 prolapses for the lowest farm. For each sow that died or was euthanized, our participating sow farm managers classified their death into one of these eight categories. Three of these categories were prolapses. Vaginal or uterine prolapses accounted for 15% of mortality. Rectal prolapses accounted for 4%. And 2% of sows were classified as having both rectal and vaginal prolapses. If we add these together, that gives us a total of 21% of all mortality that was due to some sort of prolapse. 6% of mortality was due to difficulty farrowing or retained piglets, 2% to disease, 3% intestinal complication, 29% lameness, and unknown or other was the largest category at 39%. When we look at total mortality, the average for all farms was 12.7%, 2.7% due to prolapses, and 10% due to non-prolapse mortality. The farm with the highest total mortality had 23.8% mortality, and the farm with the lowest overall mortality was at 4% for the year. Here again, if we think about what that would mean for a 5,000 sow farm, the highest farm would have lost 1,190 sows, almost 23 per week, and the lowest farm would have lost 200 sows last year, almost 4 a week. So we see a huge variation in the industry, one that impacts economics, animal welfare, and worker morale. But this also shows that there's an opportunity to move some of these high mortality farms down lower. This chart shows the average prolapse rate for all farms on the study over time. As we mentioned before, the average for all farms for the year is 2.7%. We see that we fall down under this 2.5% line in June, and then it pops back up in October. To look at the data in a different way, we divide farms into three groups based on their annualized prolapse rate. The first group was the 20% of farms with the lowest overall prolapse rate for the year. These are shown in yellow and had an average of 0.9% annualized prolapses. The middle 60% of farms had an average of 2.4% annualized prolapses and are shown in gray. The 20% of farms with the highest annualized prolapses had an average of 5.5% for the whole year. If we break it up by quarters, we see a potential seasonal trend, especially in farms with a higher prolapse rate. For that group, the prolapse rate averaged 6% during the colder weather of both quarter one and quarter four. In quarter two, they go down to 5%, and quarter three prolapse rate for those farms with high prolapse incidence was down to 4%. Which is still higher than the average farms shown in gray. For more information, please go to our website at piglivability.org, where you can subscribe and all our email updates will be sent directly to your inbox. You can also email me at chipmana@iastate.edu. Stay tuned for more videos. Thanks for watching.